Schuckman, 6 years the elder of Inoue. Mizuki stands 5'4" tall, 2 inches taller than Schuckman. Both came in under 115. The record there for Mizuki, 9-4. Schuckman, 11-8. Let's throw it up to Joe Martinez for our official introductions of the strawweight contest.
Well, Fight Fans, we are set to go with the next fight tonight. 3 rounds again, this in the strawweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, a karate fighter standing 5'4" tall, weighing it officially 114 1/3 pounds. Her professional record stands at 9 victories and 4 defeats. Fighting out of Nagoya, Japan, here is Mizuki Inoue. And across the cage stands her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist standing 5'2" tall. She weighed in officially 115 pounds and had 19 professional bouts, has a record of 11 victories and 8 defeats. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, here is Lacey, the Lady Schuckman! Referee in charge of the action is Jason Herzog.
Jason Herzog getting the strawweight assignment. Japan's Mizuki against Colorado Schuckman. And here we go. No touch of gloves. Mizuki takes the center of the cage. Schuckman comes forward early, initiates a clinch.
Yeah, Schuckman wants this fight to be on the ground, but, you know, interestingly, Mizuki said she was going to finish this fight if it went to the ground.
Different approach for Schuckman than against Jenny Liu. Liu, she kept it as a kickboxing affair. Overwhelming Liu. Now Schuckman working hard for this takedown. She's in deep on it. Beautiful takedown by Schuckman.
Nice slam. She immediately goes to Neon Valley, but you can see Mizuki's...
A hard elbow there by Schuckman.
Mizuki's scrambling there, but she's not in a great position right now.
We talked about that pressure from Schuckman. Probably wanted to employ it early. She does that now. See Mizuki trying to fish a leg in there. The corner of Schuckman calling to get mounts. Mizuki gives her back. Now Schuckman tries to take it one hook in. Very impressive here early by Schuckman.
Schuckman's doing a fantastic job of breaking her down. Mizuki's trying to stay as tight as possible, but she actually pulled her choking hand into her head.
Schuckman trying to go for a crossface, got a little bit too high there. Now Mizuki capitalizes, gets back to the feet.
Very calm and very well done by Mizuki. She was in danger, she just turned the tide.
In the case of anything you can do, I can do better. Mizuki back on top now here in half guard. A lot of time here for Mizuki to do work. 3.5 here remains in round one. We've already seen one strawweight fight tonight deliver an action. More strawweights in the cage now. Don't forget, strawweight title on the line. Olivia Souza defends against Deanna Bennett. Our co-main event coming up a little bit later on here.
And you can see the way that Lacey is employing her right hand in this. She was framing the face. Now she's trying to trap the elbow of Mizuki. Trap the bicep of Mizuki to keep her from passing all the way over, to keep that kind of pressure on her head. Mizuki's doing a great job of knee sliding through like that. When you're doing jiu-jitsu, when you're fighting on the ground, you have to be able to go head and body.
Mizuki now takes back, teeing off on Schuckman. Schuckman forced to cover up here. Oh, now she's going to get on top. In some danger, though, as Mizuki was trying to get a choke, not able to do so. Now she needs to be wary of that right arm. Looked like Mizuki was trying to frame it up, but now she is in the closed guard of Mizuki. Now Mizuki framed up in an arm bar here. She's got it. She's going to try to go belly down. Julie, what is... Lacey's got to hold on to that arm, make sure she doesn't let it get extended, but Mizuki definitely has her in a precarious situation.
Yeah, Mizuki's doing a very good job of being calm, as is Lacey. She's blocking it out. Mizuki's at the right angle to really crank on that. Lacey's got to be very, very careful of getting rolled just like this. It can really get extended, especially, you know, she's doing a nice job of blocking out like that, but that arm is extended right now.
Can't see where the elbow is in this position. She's trying to pass it through. It might be more of the forearm right here, but Schuckman's still in trouble.
Oh, nope, Schuckman gets out.
Now she's free. Now she might go for an inverted triangle here, Julie.
Good gracious.
How about this?
Nice grappling. You know, sometimes fighting for that top position can put you in more danger. Mizuki was doing a great job of locking on that arm bar, but as soon as Lacey escaped, she was able to scramble to a better position. from the bottom.
Both of these women really fighting offensively here. Both have had their moments here in 3.5 minutes. Mizuki on top, still fighting off this choke.
Yeah, but her...
It looked like
was
she
that
tapped.
A tap? I don't know. Her chin looks like it's out, though.
It was definitely a weird thing. Sometimes in mixed martial arts, you try to adjust yourself, and a brief adjustment can look like a tap. It looked like Mizuki tapped, but it wasn't three distinctive taps, so Jason Herzog doesn't stop. Now Mizuki's trying to answer. It'll be interesting to see if Schuckman, maybe his posture was broken by that tap.
Possibly. Look at the way that Schuckman is basing off of the cage with her feet. She's trying to get enough energy to turn around as she is now. Mizuki's riding that energy, she's riding that momentum to once again go for that armbar, this time from a top position.
The fence might be her enemy here as Mizuki might not be able to extend it, but Schuckman defending now. Mizuki throws some strikes to the body.
That
she definitely
has
space.
Now.
Lacey Schuckman trying to fight this off. Mizuki Inoue trying to get a first round submission. Schuckman very comfortable here. I think she looked at her corner and said she tapped him.
Well, it's not the time to argue that now. That comes later. She's out of the armbar danger now.
Now scramble ensues here. Mizuki trying to solidify her top position. 20 seconds remain in round number one. Schuckman going for what could be a guillotine. Doesn't have the position, the fence.
Mizuki's doing a nice job of using the fence to block that out, block the momentum of that.
Final 10 seconds here, round number one. A lot of action here in this opening 5 minutes. Little flurry to end it.
Oh,
a little bit after the bell there. Herzog warning Schuckman. That round had everything, Julie. A little bit of controversy, but a lot of action.
It did, and you know, regardless if Lacey thinks that she tapped or not, regardless if you see that at home, the fight is still going on. Let's watch this ground and pound from Mizuki. Very, very vicious when she got the back. Remember, she was just in a position where her back was given up. She reversed it, got on top, and you can see how Lacey's doing the reverse. Watch the way Lacey is tied up in that armbar. She escapes, rolls through, and watch, this is the phantom tap. Is this a tap or isn't this a tap? We'll let you decide this at home. It looks like a tap to me, but however, her chin was actually out. She's through the legs.
Right, and you know, her arm is controlled in a manner that she doesn't have full range of it. So it might have been her trying to adjust, but you know, not being able to move the way she wanted to. My thing is, if your opponent doesn't tap three distinct times and the referee doesn't break it up, don't let go. I don't know if Schuckman let go, but you know, that'll be something we can ask her post-fight. But a solid 5 minutes, very close fight here in the opening round. Mizuki Inoue, Lacey Schuckman, round two underway. Exchanging kicks here early.
Yeah,
beautiful kick to the body there by Mizuki.
I was going to say, it doesn't look like either one of these ladies have slowed down at all. They're still going just as fast.
Mizuki looking for a trip here. Right hands, uppercut.
Mizuki has definitely fixed what she said, not being aggressive enough. She's pushing forward. She's doing a great job of being aggressive and really trying to get Lacey on the fence.
Mizuki definitely pushing forward here with strikes. Schuckman responds. Now Schuckman lowers her elevation, tries to get a trip takedown, unable to do so. Beautiful throw by Mizuki.
Yeah, that trip gives up your balance a little bit. It pushes your hips to a position where you can get tossed like that. Mizuki capitalized on that beautifully.
Mizuki setting up here in side control. Knees to the body here by Mizuki. The corner of Schuckman asking her to shrimp in, try to get a better position here, guard, half guard, something. You do not want to let a grappler of Mizuki's caliber hang out in side control for too long. Beautiful strikes there.
You certainly do not. However, Lacey, with her submission attempts and all the scrambling from the first round, shows she's very game on the ground.
Lacey Schuckman is having a conversation with her corner here.
Not the best time for it.
Beautiful mountain. Mizuki,
look at
nice
the way
balance
she,
here.
Yeah, look at the way she threaded her legs in there. She was able to hide her toes underneath Lacey.
Now she postures up, forces Schuckman to move. Now Mizuki trying to rain down some punches. Schuckman covering up. Jason Herzog right on top of it.
Extremely strong ground and pound from Mizuki.
Mizuki picked a beautiful right hand there, went underneath the armpit of Schuckman. Schuckman eating hammer fist here.
Looks like a couple of those landed to the back of the head. Herzog definitely called her on that one.
Mizuki acknowledged. Hard left hands here by Mizuki.
And the problem is, a lot of them are coming through and a lot of them aren't. The problem with that is, if Lacey's not engaging, if she's not showing us, you know, a strong enough defense, this can be stopped right here.
You need to properly and intelligently defend yourself. That is up to the discretion of the referee.
A lot of blood in the face of Lacey Schuckman now.
Schuckman, yep, definitely lacerated. A lot of punishment here in the second round for Mizuki. Yeah, Lacey Schuckman's face is a mess here. Still game though, Mizuki trying to fish for a rear naked. Fighting the hands is Schuckman.
And what's beautiful about what Mizuki is doing is she's improving position, hitting, trying to finish, improving. She's going for that armbar again.
There it is. Mizuki trying to get this armbar. She's had the position a few times. Schuckman stacks. We'll see if she tries to slam out. Wisely, Mizuki grabs that leg. Beautiful defensive grappling by Schuckman.
Wonderfully done. And you can see she tried to get top position. Mizuki was aware of it, pushed.
Oh, Mizuki flirting with some punches here. Sorry to cut you off, Julie. It looked like Mizuki was going to use that opportunity to try to finish this fight, but Schuckman still game.
Schuckman once again using the cage, trying to climb her way out of this position with her feet.
Mizuki launched an elbow there that didn't quite get through. Now Schuckman going for a heel hook. Mizuki spins nicely out of danger.
Heels to the kidney! Heels to the kidney! Go! Heels to the kidney!
Very strong strikes right there.
Mizuki trying to use this position as an offensive one. Schuckman was going for the leg. She bails on it now.
Punches up, elbow up. Yes, again, right elbow up.
You can hear Schuckman's corner calling for up elbows from that position. Schuckman is bracing out with that right knee. She's trying to push Mizuki away from her. She's trying to maintain wrist control, but Mizuki is able at times to rip her wrists out. Oh,
beautiful sweep attempt there by Schuckman. Initiates a scramble now. Inoue looking for a leg lock, but Mizuki back on top. She bails on it. Mizuki's throwing punches from every angle. It looked like she's gonna try to stand now. She came with the right hand.
Stand up when you can.
Final 20 seconds here, round number two. This round has been all Mizuki.
Elbow when you can. Spike it backwards. Yep, again.
Touch over 10 seconds here. Schuckman's gonna probably survive this round, but she has a lot of work to do to get back in this fight here, round number three. Finishing touches here from Mizuki on the round, an offensive onslaught from the Japanese fighter.
She's done a fantastic job of really turning the tide from that initial exchange where she was actually defending her back to really making Lacey Schuckman suffer.
A very offensive-minded Mizuki Inoue lumping up the face of Lacey Schuckman. Let's take a look at the takedown here, Julie. Some fantastic work done by both of these women.
You can see that Schuckman, in attempting to do those inside trips, gives up that judo toss to Mizuki exactly where she wants it. And this extremely vicious ground and pound from Mizuki. She's holding her base very, very well and getting awesome strikes off of that base. Now again, she goes for that armbar multiple times throughout this fight, and Schuckman is becoming very savvy to it. She stacks her up. She looks like she's going to slam. She wisely adjusts when she feels the hook on the leg and is able to pull through. When Mizuki tries to sweep, Schuckman is able to absolutely come around that, get her own ground. But then again, in this scramble, these ladies are just queens of the scramble. Mizuki once again gets the better.
A beautiful display of defensive grappling there in the second round by Schuckman. A purple belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu really has her defensive grappling on point. She was caught in a few pretty difficult situations, but still in this one as we head into round number three.
Yeah, what I like about what Schuckman's doing is she becomes very aggressive. She not only defends on the ground, she's looking for her own sub. She knows that's how to finish it. Super fast hands from Inoue, or excuse me, Mizuki right now. She likes to be called just by her first name.
Oh, beautiful evasion of that kick by Mizuki. Really sitting down on her punches. I mean, I think the confidence has grown throughout this fight for Mizuki.
I think so as well.
Very light on her feet here in this third round is Mizuki. Schuckman's still coming forward with a jab.
She's coming forward, but she seems to have slowed down a little bit. She's not as light on her feet as Mizuki is now.
Mizuki rushes in. Combination of punches ends up in the clinch.
Nice shot, though, right there.
Schuckman's going to be in this until the bitter end. She will not go quietly. Double unders here for Mizuki. Going for a trip takedown now.
Oh, that put her head in a bad position there.
Schuckman might try to sell out here for this guillotine. Inoue settles here in half. It'd be hard to finish this here, but Mizuki did leave her head open. Was susceptible.
And she's doing a nice job of defending that. I don't know how much danger she's in, but you know, I can be wrong right there. Her neck is definitely trapped, but her legs are working to alleviate the pressure and to put her in a better spot.
Mizuki very patient here. Schuckman really holding onto the head. She doesn't really want to let it go because she would be in a very tough spot if Mizuki is able to posture up and rain down strikes.
But Mizuki, by placing her head on the canvas like that, she's actually doing a good job of countering the pressure on her neck. When she places her head on the canvas, she can cross face and she can get her own strikes in. She doesn't appear to be that phased from this position right now.
Now the composure here on display from the 21-year-old Mizuki. She gets free. Now she's going to try to punish Schuckman.
And it has been the story of this fight where Schuckman is getting Mizuki into strange, dangerous positions, and Mizuki is able to turn that to her advantage.
Mizuki postures up once again now. Schuckman turns to her left, almost belly down. Hard right hand there by Mizuki, gets through in another.
The problem with covering up like that is you have to stay active if the other person is hitting.
Left hand's here now by Mizuki. Schuckman covering up. Schuckman's taking a lot of punishment here. Jason Herzog is cognizant of that, telling Schuckman she's got to move.
And Schuckman is aware that that armbar is coming. She's already setting up that spin into it. However, she's taking some damage right here.
Schuckman able to try to break that positioning once again.
And she looks like as though she's attempting to put her left leg around the face of Mizuki to break that down, to get some more leverage for herself.
Mizuki now utilizing both of her arms to try to isolate the right arm of Schuckman. A lot of time here to work for it. Over 90 seconds remain. Schuckman now on top, trying to, again, still defend this arm bar. And there can be pressure on that arm even if it isn't fully extended as well, Julie.
Oh, yeah.
There it is!
Oh.
Just like that, Mizuki getting it done, arm bar stoppage of Lacey Schuckman.
Well, you called that one. There definitely was pressure on that arm, TJ. You know, we could see Lacey almost the moment where she breaks on that and she knows that she's been subbed.
That was a dominant performance by the Japanese-based Mizuki. Fantastic stuff. You know, she lost to Alexa Grasso last year, but it was a fight that showed a lot of her ability. She gets the win tonight. It was a bit of a showcase here for Mizuki.
It definitely was. She put her best skills up there for us so we could see a more evolved, a stronger, more mature Mizuki. Very strong ground and pound. You know, of course, she won the fight with a submission, but I'm very impressed with the strength she was generating from those punches from the top.
You're not going to find many 21-year-olds with the arsenal and the ability of Mizuki. She is showing tonight why strawweights, for my money, Julie, is the best division in all of mixed martial arts. It's a talent pool that seems to be endless here in Invicta. Invicta has had their hands in everything, producing the best strawweights in the world, and tonight we see exactly why.
Yeah, and great camaraderie between the two of these. You know, Lacey called out Mizuki. She said she wanted to fight her. She got her wish. She came up short, but a lot of class between these two women.
Armbar stoppage goes the way of Mizuki. Let's get the official time. Here's Joe.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes to the official time. 3 minutes, 41 seconds, round number three. Submission by armbar for your winner from Nagoya, Japan, Mizuki Inoue.